we added 1.645 million subscribers in Q4, which made the year's total for T-Mobile 4.4 million. And that's off of a historic loss. So that's very important for us, a big turnaround that certainly impacts our parents in Deutsche Telekom. We also announced that based on crowdsourced data from speedtest.net, we are now the nation's fastest 4G LTE network, which is fascinating, and it's going to cause AT&T to take down some signs about being the fastest. And because of that, we asked the question, why not go to T-Mobile? And the answer was early termination fees. And we believe very strongly that the world should be without contracts, and the early termination fee is something, not a program. We are permanently going to eliminate early termination fees and pay up to $650, both in the device and per line for families. And we can do that. We have a low cost structure, very low churn, and you know, we've given guidance and we believe we can do this profitably.
Well, one of the interesting aspects of this is just recently when your competitors offered money to tempt people away from your services, you said that smacked of desperation. And yet, here you are, perhaps the pot calling the kettle black, you're offering even more money to tempt people away from them.
Yeah, very, very important difference, Nina. First of all, this early termination fee elimination applies to all carriers, Verizon, Sprint, AT&T, or anybody. And it's a standard belief that the world needs to go in that direction. Unlike one of our competitors who offered a $200 bill credit to migrate back to a standard program. And it really wasn't a philosophy or a program. And I will tell you that in Q4, our porting ratios with AT&T are well over 2-to-1, which means at a rate of 2-to-1, their customers are coming to us. So it's pretty clear that we've hurt them now in the network speed as well. And so it was a desperate, guided move. When I attack somebody, I make it very clear. We're going after everybody's customers.
But the key issue is that you might get them to switch for the next year or so, and then they'll just switch back to another company with a different offering because you're not putting forward a contract that locks them in here.
And what a beautiful world it would be. And in effect, what we want is consumer full flexibility. And frankly, what's taking place, Nina, is this shifting. And the reason it's so difficult is because of the phone subsidy that takes place by carriers as opposed to the equipment providers. And then the term of the contract is required to pay back that handset. As a carrier investing capital in our network, we can be profitable on a month-to-month basis with people. And then if they want to buy a phone, we can help them with financing. These are separate items. Yeah. And once the world gets to that and people can flexibly move, it's going to be a very healthy industry. And we, for one, know that we will be profitable and growing in that new world as well.
You've had a very entertaining week. You've been thrown out of a party by AT&T, apparently a gate crasher, as if you couldn't have been spotted with that T-Mobile T-shirt that you're famous for wearing. That must have been a publicity stunt.
Now, come on, Nina. You're telling me you don't love Macklemore? So, you know, I wanted to go see Macklemore, and I went, and I had no ill intentions, and very large human beings escorted me out of the building, and frankly, in hindsight, thank you, because it was seen as a populist statement by a company. And, I really just wanted to see one of my favorite bands from the Seattle area. And I think because of that, I'm now going to the Grammys in a few weeks, and I'm going to get to see Macklemore.